In most of the remote locations, nobody would be sure about the quality of the water. In that case, portable water treatment method is used. For example, in the deserted areas, portable water treatment plants are used for the military sites. During the process, the treatment done for the production of drinking water involves removal of impurities from raw water to the water which is pure enough for human consumption, without any adverse health effects. The impurities can be in various forms such as fungi, viruses, algae, bacteria, and other minerals. Now getting into the treatment process done in oceans, as it is the largest source of water on Earth. The seawater could be purified to get fresh water by a process called desalination. The process of desalination is to remove common salts from the salt water and make it clean enough to drink. Desalination process involves the reverse osmosis process to extract the pure drinking water from seawater. Seawaters are extracted using the wells, which is penetrated deep under the seabed. The seawater is passed through the sand and polish it to filter it further. Next, the salt water, which is obtained, gets purified to get fresh water using a reverse osmosis process. High amount of pressure is applied to the salt water, forcing it to pass through the several osmosis membranes. Since the pressurized seawater passes through the osmosis membrane surfaces, water molecules are forced through the multiple membranes, leaving the salt molecules behind to get soft water. With the added minerals, the water is pure enough to drink. Assume that in our homes, the sewage water is taken to the purifying treatment plant. Here, the purifying treatment plant is nothing but upflow anaerobic sludge blanket. The process of the treatment is to collect the sewage water in a large tank. In the UASB tank, the presence of oxygen molecules should be avoided. UASB is an anaerobic process, forming a blanket of sludges, which remains in the tank. The wastewater flows upward through the blanket, and it is processed to leave behind small granules of sludges, which then reaches a saturation limit in a couple of months, and then should be treated in a proper way. At the end of this process, we get purified drinking water, and the biogas, a byproduct. The biogas is nothing but a high concentration of methane, which can be captured and used as energy source.